So you see that there is a victim which is lying on the floor. The first thing you ensure scene safety. Then you check the response of the victim, whether he's been responding by tapping his shoulder. Respond nahi kar raha hai, aapko phone uthana hai aur emergency response number call karna hai. Then by the time help arrives, you check the pulse of the patient, that is a carotid pulse. Pulse present nahi hai, 5 se 10 second ke beech mein aapne pulse check karni hai. Then you identify the center of the chest and you need to start giving CPR या chest compressions. Chest compressions का रेट 30 compressions होने चाहिए और उसके बाद followed by 2 breaths होना चाहिए. ये देखिएगा 30, अब ये 2 breaths दे रहे हैं. ऐसे आप कम से कम 5 cycle करिए या 2 minute तक करिए और उसके बाद आप ये देखिए कि उसकी pulse वापस आई है या नहीं आई है. एक और इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज़ ये है कि आपको अगर कंफर्टेबल नहीं है उस पेशेंट को ब्रेथ देना, तो आप उसको सिर्फ हैंड्स ओनली CPR या कंप्रेशन ओनली CPR भी दे सकते हैं. दैट कुड ऑल्सो एक्चुअली सेव अ पेशेंट्स लाइफ. सो इन द एंड मोटिव इज टू सेव समबडीज लाइफ. You can see that while eating food, he suddenly had some kind of obstruction in his throat, and he looks like he's not able to swallow it, and he has some kind of choking. So this two hands putting around the neck, this is called a universal sign of choking. His friend who was sitting next to him immediately recognizes him. He asked him to stand in front. First thing he does is he puts his right leg below, between his two legs, because that's the support he is trying to give him. So because in case he's going to try a maneuver to take out that choking food particle, in this entire process, in case he collapses, he will be able to give him a support on his leg. The next thing is he's going to demonstrate a Hemlich's maneuver. So he's going to use the fist of his, right hand. He's trying to locate his umbilicus, put his fist 2 centimeters above the umbilicus, use his other hand, which is gonna use to give him a thrust. Once this position is confirmed, he's gonna give him upward and backward thrust. So as this video is for demonstration, he's not gonna actually give him. So upward and backward thrust, he gives him 3 or 4 times, and you see suddenly that the patient puts out the foreign body. The foreign body comes out. In this entire procedure, if you see or if you note that your patient has collapsed or he has become unconscious, you make him lie down on a flat surface, and you follow the steps of BLS. That is, you check for his carotid pulse for at least 5 seconds, not more than 10 seconds. And if the pulse is not present, you straight away start with the chest compressions. Thank you. Okay, so now we are going to demonstrate that if a child less than 1 year of age, who is called an infant, if he chokes, what are you supposed to do? So as you can see, the infant has been taken into a person who is going to try to remove his choking part in one of his forearms. And as you see, the head of the baby is slightly below the level of his forearm, and the fingers on which the person is holding the child, he is not compressing any of his soft tissue structures on the face. Rather than that, his fingers are on his bony prominence of the face. Now, once you position the child this way, you are going to give him 5 back thrusts in between his shoulder blades. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, you are going to turn the child, put him in your another forearm, and again the head of the child would be slightly below his forearm. And again, now you are going to give him chest thrust using the two-finger technique. 5 chest thrusts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're gonna continue this till the time the child has stopped choking or the child becomes unconscious. In this entire thing, if you see or you find that the child has become unconscious, you make him lie down on a flat surface and follow the steps of pediatric BLS. That is, check for his brachial pulse. for 5 seconds, not more than 10 seconds. If the pulse is not palpable, you start giving him CPR, either by the two finger technique or by thumb encircling technique. Thank you. Okay, so in this part of the video, we are going to demonstrate the importance of cervical spine immobilization. So to start with, very often we all encounter road traffic accident victims, and we really want to help them after the Good Samaritan law was passed by the government of Supreme Court, that every Good Samaritan can help a road traffic accident victim without being asked any questions. So whenever you approach a road traffic accident victim and you see that he is obviously bleeding from his head, or there is an external sign of bleeding from anywhere other part of the body, so you always suspect that along with his head injury, he might have cervical spine injury. So at that moment of time, as a first aid provider, what you can do is you can immobilize his cervical spine using just very basic things. So in this video, or this part of the video, we are going to demonstrate to you that how you first immobilize the spine, and then how you can use just a newspaper to put up a cervical collar. In the hospital setting, we use a classical Philadelphia collar for our patients, but obviously that's not possible in an out of hospital setting. So we see that how we demonstrate the cervical spine. So you go behind the patient's head and you bend down on your knees. You put your both hands below his shoulder. Use your two arms to kind of straighten up his head, or rather I should say that to prevent any kind of head movements laterally. Okay. So once this is done, the other person, basically what he has done is he has basically used a newspaper. He has folded the newspaper into two. Over each other, so it's kind of become a slight rigid structure. Okay, and the next thing is he slides that newspaper below the victim's neck without disturbing or making the neck move, and just below, after sliding, what he has done is he just encircles that newspaper around that patient's neck. Once this is encircled, you can apply a sellotape or bigger size sellotape, so that this is kind of a quick cervical immobilization which you have done just using a newspaper. This part of the video, we are going to demonstrate to you that if you have a road traffic accident victim and you actually are not sure whether he has suffered any back injury or what you call a spine injury, what quickly as a first aid provider you can do. So you need 3 or 4 people to understand this thing which we are going to demonstrate you. It's called basically log roll. It's to just safely put a board below the patient's back till the time he's moved to a hospital setting and a further management is done. But you cannot just straight away turn the patient onto one side. This is a procedure which we are going to demonstrate. So first step is, we are going to, as we said on the earlier part of the video, we are going to immobilize the cervical spine. So one of our view would be demonstrating it. Again, put the hands below the patient's shoulder. Use his two forearms to make the cervical spine straight. The other two persons are on the side of the patient. The first person, first hand is on the patient's shoulder. The other hand is on his pelvis. Similarly, the other person who is there on the other end of the patient, or the lower end of the patient, his on one hand is below the first patient person's hand, and the other hand on his leg. You're gonna turn on the count of 3. I'm gonna make a count, and the fourth person who is standing there next to the patient, he's gonna quickly examine, look for a sign of any injury to his back, and also will put up the spine board below his back. So we'll do it on the count of 1, 2, and 3. So we just quickly examine that whether the back is injured or not, and the next thing he's gonna do is he's gonna put the spine board below the patient. So this will basically enable that the patient's back, even if he has some injury, it's not further aggravated, and the back spine is exactly intact the way it was. So this simple thing can prevent the further injury to his spine till the time he's been shifted to any particular hospital. Now in this video, we used a spine board. Obviously this is not available with you. So as a first aid provider, what you can use is you can use a wooden plank, a hard wooden plank, that you can put it behind the patient's back, or you can use it a thick cardboard or a carton sheet. Thank you.